So hi, hello and welcome again. Microbehunter here. There are approximately 30 to 40 trillion cells in an adult human body. That's a huge number. It's 30 with 12 zeros. It's unimaginably large. However, there are even more bacteria growing on our body, especially on our skin and in our digestive system. There are more bacteria than actually we have body cells. And the question now, of course, arises, where in the world are they, right? How can it be that actually we are made of more cells, which are actually not ourselves, but which are actually bacteria? So this is a little bit of a paradox, which I would like to explain. Well, actually, the answer is fairly simple. It is possible to have so many bacteria growing on our skin and in our digestive system because bacteria are so much smaller. How big is a cell of a body? Well, cells can vary in size a lot, but the average human cell has approximately 10 micrometers across. I mean, yes, I know there are cells that are much larger. For example, the human egg cell can theoretically even be seen as a small dot, right? It has about a tenth of a millimeter. There are also cells that are extremely long. For example, certain nerve cells can even be over a meter long, still very thin and therefore still not possible to see them without a microscope. Essentially, the average cell has about 10 micrometers across, which is approximately 10 times smaller than what we are able to see without a microscope. So essentially, if you make a tiny dot, or let's take the diameter of a hair, the diameter of a hair is approximately a tenth of a millimeter across. 1/10 of the diameter over here, that's approximately the size of an average human cell. And bacteria are actually even smaller, and they have a diameter of 1 micrometer. So they are 10 times smaller than an average body cell. Now, however, this can be a little bit deceiving because that's only when you measure the diameter, because the volume of a cell, is a three-dimensional structure. Volume has height, length, and also depth. And that means if a bacterium is 1/10 of the diameter, then it actually has 1/1000th of the volume. And this basically means that 1,000 bacteria are able to fit into the space of one body cell. That's quite a lot. And this basically means that if you take me as an example, I have got 70 kilograms. So that's 70,000 grams. And this basically means I've got at least 70 grams of bacteria growing on my skin and in my digestive system, but most likely, of course, much more. 70 grams, I mean, that's if I eat a bowl of yogurt, for example, then I'm already, I don't know, maybe doubling or tripling the total number of bacteria that I have, because their bacterial density is also so high in yogurt. So you see, if you just see those proportions a little bit, then actually it becomes much more easily imaginable where all of those bacteria have reside on our body. And those bacteria are extremely important because they make up our so-called our biome, and they are really important for not only for digesting our food but also for preventing other harmful bacteria from growing. So essentially, yeah, they are part of who I am. It's kind of a little bit strange to think that actually I'm made of more cells that are actually not part of my body than I've got body cells. But then again, yeah, I'm also bacteria in that sense. Yeah, kind of strange to think a little bit about that. Yeah, but biology is weird sometimes. I know. All the best and happy microbe hunting, and bye bye. See you in the next video.